Just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. Let's head down to the coin toss now, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Louisiana Tech is lined up for the opening kickoff, so here we go. Taken at the five. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown. Let's find out.
Receiving team.
That one will put the offense in a hole, and they'll try to get some of that back on this upcoming play. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. He's tackled at the 19-yard line.
Followed the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and two.
Tackled around the 21-yard line. There's a player hurt. It doesn't look to be that bad. From their own 21-yard line. Third down. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver.
Accuracy is such a vital part of being a quarterback. You've got to have an ability to lay the ball right into your guy's hands.
Lee is back to receive. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. So the offense will come out in opponent's territory for their first drive of the game.
They couldn't have asked for better field position than this.
There's a strike complete. Tackle made at about the 39-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. First down, pick up by the tailback.
You can see how comfortable this guy is with that football in his arms.
Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
That makes it second and 10.
Second and 10. Ball on the 36. Run up the middle.
With the tackle.
Man left.
That's a gain of seven in the play.
Third down.
Screen pass. He's got his halfback. And they make the stop at the 33. A 4-yard loss.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. Well, Kirk, we saw this kid head to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury, and now we see he's back on the sideline. That's good news. Looks like he should be able to get back in the action. And they come away empty-handed. Now, this one's scoreless. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Gets it out quickly. And he's tackled at the 46.
That's good for a gain of 13 yards. First down.
Mike 34.
Finds his man and they take him down immediately.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
Watch number 12. Watch number 12.
Motion.
Hand off, and he's met immediately. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 44. Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. Young gains about 5 yards on the play. Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position. Gets it away. Wait a minute, he's going to throw. Not sure about that play call as they fail on fourth down. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. They give to the tailback. Runs outside for a nice game.
That makes it second and six.
Gets it. He's in space. He's at the 40. They'll bring him down at the 34-yard line.
I think he was going to go to his tight end the whole way, but the defense didn't expect it. Sometimes those big guys can fool defenders into thinking they're blocking.
And down he goes at about the 21. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
Quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
Quick pass. Knocked out of bounds around the 17-yard line.
That makes it 7-6.
He's taken down at the 16. Pick and he dropped it.
Henderson is the intended receiver on the play.
They'll call on the field goal unit here. Louisiana Tech is looking to go up by three. Kicks up and it splits the uprights. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the one. Tackle made at the 26. The Bulldogs have found a way to shut this offense down, but hey, it's still early in a football game.
Yeah, give them a lot of credit for the way they've played up to this point, but just based on watching these teams and preparing for this game, do not be surprised to see this offense eventually find itself and start to execute much better.
He rifles it. From their own 26-yard line, it's second down.
Allison was the intended receiver on the play. That brings up third and 10.
He wants it all, going long. Oh, he had a shot at the pick. Lee is back deep to return. Oh, excellent punt. He gets out to about the 38-yard line. Louisiana Tech's a team that was supposed to roll over and play dead in this football game, and they're not doing that.
I think what we've seen so far is some good execution, but just more of an attitude. They have shown up to play in this game with a confidence and a belief in one another that they're going to pull off an upset today.
Louisiana Tech is up by three. gains his way to the 46-yard line.
Gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
Here's an opening. Brought down at the 41-yard line. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. Taken down around the 40-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 31. He throws it. Catches it, and he's looking for more. Touchdown! Big play! Tough time defending that one.
Well, Brad, one of the things with this defense is you leave yourself vulnerable in one-on-one coverage. Great throw by the quarterback and great speed by the receiver.
Where was the coverage there? There wasn't anybody near him at all. And he adds the extra point. A five-play, 62-yard drive. And they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Dudek from the one. He's tackled at the 26-yard line. The Bulldogs are smothering the opposition so far today. What's this offense got to do to get off the schneid?
Well, you talk to offensive coordinators about that, and they'll say we've got to find our go-to guy. Who are our players that we know we can count on, and what are the plays that we typically feel the most confident about? That's usually where the offenses tend to go when they're getting shut down.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. He's tackled at the 36. There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Taken down as he works the left for a nice gain.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. First down.
Had his hands on it and drops it.
That could have been a huge shift in momentum if they were able to hold on to that one. Wow, that was close.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 40. Throws complete and he stopped immediately. First quarter is over. Watch out, folks. This one is turning into a major upset. 10-0, Louisiana Tech. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two.
I'm coming.
Makes it out to about the 43.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That makes it first and 10.
The defender had it and then dropped it.
Allison, the intended receiver on the play.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. The Bulldogs had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete.
Well, that's a great play here by the defense, getting pressure on the quarterback, and the result is a bad throw. These are the kind of plays that can really impact the football game because the defense can build some confidence after getting after a quarterback like that.
Throws into coverage, just picked off. Tackle at the 35.
That's the last thing they needed to happen was an interception. They're trying to fight to get back into this game, and to have that miscue, now it's really up to their defense to try to help them out.
First and 10. Ball on the 35. He is drilled at the 37.
Well, you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
That'll bring up second down.
It's just me and you. It's just me and you. 33 in the night. Ready. Check, check. Regular.
Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in.
Number 18. Intended receiver on the play.
Here's third and 11. Ball on the 37-yard line. Going for it all to the end zone. Almost picked off.
As a defender, you want to keep your hands up. Maybe you can come away with a pick or at least deflect the ball.
It's up. Looks long enough. No good. He missed it to the right. And the offense will take the field, and they're certainly hoping to do better than they did on their last drive, which ended with a turnover.
The game is in danger of getting out of hand early. It's very, very important that they not only hang on to the football this drive, but they also need to get a score on the board as well.
Rid of this one.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback, and right now I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
It's third and 8. Ball on the 39. He almost had it, but it's incomplete. Lee will be the return man. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. He fields it at the 17. He's pushed out of bounds at the 34. Louisiana Tech's offense came out of the gate like gangbusters, but they have slowed things down now.
I just don't sense the same energy from this team that we saw early in the game when they just came out. They're ready, they're excited. It seems that they kind of let their foot off the accelerator, but now they're opening up an opportunity for this team to get back into this game and maybe take the lead.
And he hits him hard at the 33-yard line.
That'll bring up second and 11.
Man left.
We've got a second and 11. Ball on the 33-yard line. He makes his way to about the 48.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
He fights forward to about the 49.
That's a gain of one on the play. That brings up second and 9.
Gets it out to his receiver, and he can't hang on.
Turner was the intended receiver on the play.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 42. Throws it deep. Missed him. They're really fortunate that wasn't intercepted.
Not a very smart decision by the quarterback. He had no shot at completing it.
They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. He's out to the 30. He gets out to about the 32-yard line.
I think this defense has played well enough to be able to win this game, obviously. But at some point, you'd love to see their own offense feed off of some of the confidence that their defense is playing with, because up to this point, the defense is keeping them in the game. The offense isn't quite doing enough to be able to build on that lead.
Slings it. Good tackle there in space.
That's a game of 6 on the play. That brings up second and five.
Strike to his receiver, no good.
Number 18 is the intended receiver on the play.
From their own 38-yard line, third down. There's a strike complete. Tackle made right around the 38-yard line. Lee awaiting the return. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. And he's taken down at the 23. The offense is looking to be a little bit more successful with this drive, as they had to punt the ball away the last time they had it. The 17-yard line.
That is a loss of six on the play. That'll make it second and long.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That brings up third and 12.
Four down. Watch 14.
Pass out to the tight end. He's got the first down.
Well, we got a new quarterback in there. You have to wonder not only how will he do, but what does this do to the starter's psyche?
That's a great tackle at the 48-yard line.
That's a gain of 17. That makes it first and 10.
Look at a scramble down. He can't get away from the pressure.
A great defensive end in college football just pins his ears back and has, again, that extra instinct to know when to jump the snap count, when to take a chance on third down. It seems like they almost save their extra pass rush and extra incentive as far as their energy when it really matters on a third down, when they feel like they can beat that offensive tackle and get off the line of scrimmage a little bit quicker. And that's something that I think we've seen him do throughout this game.
And so it's another third down upcoming here. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
Well, if you missed a long field goal try, you give your opponent great field position. Punting would allow you to pin them deep and rely on the defense.
Kicks away. No good. He missed it to the left. The defense shut him down on their last drive, forcing a quick punt. Hit before he could go anywhere.
Now that's how you run a corner route. He exploded out of his cut and beat the man coverage for a new set of downs.
Mike 34.
Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver.
This quarterback needs to give his playmakers a chance to make plays. He's got to be sure he gets the ball in their hands.
From the 36-yard line, second down. Going deep. Quick throw, caught, touchdown. So they call a tight end's number, and he comes through with the score.
He did a great job here of using his size to create space for himself so the quarterback could get the ball into him without any defenders getting in the way.
You've got to admire the full extension to haul in that score. Here's the extra point to get within a field goal, and he hits the PAT. It was a quick three-play, 60-yard drive, and they get it in for seven. The score now, 10-7. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Louisiana Tech has a three-point lead. Going right, intercepted.
I just don't think he saw the defender, and he threw the ball right at him. That's what happens when you focus on one guy. You get tunnel vision.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 35-yard line. And he just gets rid of it.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. Looks middle, got his back. And they make the stop
around the 27-yard line.
It's fourth down. They're going to try a long field goal here. Illinois is down three and looking to tie it up. Is up. It's got the distance, and he splits the uprights. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. He's out to the 30, and he's tackled
right around the 34. The Bulldogs are going to call their second timeout from their own 34-yard line.
It's first down. He's taken down
at about the 45. Louisiana Tech's out of timeouts.
So we'll probably get one last heave to the end zone here before halftime. And he tackles him hard at the 37-yard line.
We've played a half of football and a 10-10 tie in this game.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
Let's not get too carried away by the numbers, but both of these teams averaging less than 6 yards per pass. It's an indication, it seems, that maybe there's not the personnel out there that really scares this defense, that can really stretch the defense.
Yeah, we talk about it all the time, having those big-time speed guys and those playmakers on the outsides that really make the cornerbacks bail and take away the deep ball. And they're not scared right now. They're just squatting on the outside and saying, you're not going to run by me, you're not going to throw it deep, and all I'm going to do is try to make sure that you catch the underneath stuff and wrap you up and tackle you. So somebody has to emerge as a playmaker, and you have to find the playmakers down the field to make some big home run plays.
Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
And the second half just about set to get started. We're dead even.
sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. Nice run there.
Well, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
So that sack will back them up a little now. They're looking at a difficult third and 13. Makes the grab, and he's got the first. He's tackled around the 39-yard line. And they get nice yardage on that run. After a decent pickup. In the shotgun and five wideouts. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. It's 2nd and 12. Ball on the 49. Just throws this one away. And this play is number 8 on the drive. He might not be able to get the pass off. He's wrapped up for the sack.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
After the sack, it's now 4th and long. At the 29. Nice yardage on the run back. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. And down he goes at about the 31. They come out in a 5-wide set. He's out of bounds around the 35-yard line. The quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Brought down at the 46-yard line.
Called a gain of 11 yards.
5 wide. Throws it, and oh, he dropped it.
That makes it
from their own 46-yard line, it's 2nd down. Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in.
Mike 34.
wants it all. No, incomplete.
Number 19, the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it 4th and 10.
Lee is back awaiting the punt. And this one is a beauty. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
It really has. They're dominating the point of attack.
This defense has had success getting after the quarterback. What we're seeing is a cat and mouse game with neither team really taking control. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping.
You know, at that point, I think, Brad, the quarterback's just better off just taking a sack. You have to be very careful as you're feeling pressure to throw the ball just to throw the ball. If you feel like you're not going to be able to make a play and the defense got you, just give up on that play and get ready for the next down.
They'll bring him down at the 43-yard line. At the 46.
Called a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Gain of 4 yards. That makes it 3rd and 2.
And he is drilled at the 42-yard line. 1st and 10, ball on the 42. He's taken down, right around the 40.
Gain of 2 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 8.
Doubles, doubles, doubles. Check 3. Jim.
Stepping up. Quick throw out to the receiver. Tackle made at about the 15-yard line.
1st down.
There's a player hurt. It doesn't look to be that bad. From the 15-yard line, 1st down. The Bulldogs had one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to return. And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
Loss of 1 yard on the play. That'll bring up 2nd and 11.
He fights forward to about the 13. He throws it away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He gets it up and it sails through the uprights. They line up to kick this one away. Fielded at the 4. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 25-yard line.
Kickoff return to 21 yards.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He passes it. Makes the grab and he's knocked out of bounds. Big play right there.
26 yards. 1st down.
And And they make the stop at the 35-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That brings up second and 5.
He steps out at the 26.
Gain of 3 yards. That'll make it 31.
And he's level at the 18-yard line.
Johnson with the tackle at the 18-yard line. First down.
Caught, and he's hit immediately.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 8.
From the 16-yard line, it's 2nd down. Dumps it out left to the running back. Now it's 1st and goal as he's knocked out after a nice gain.
That makes it 1st and goal.
And he's tackled at the 4. Brilliant work by both defenses through 3 quarters of play. Who can open it up in the 4th quarter? Whoever does has got a great chance to win. The Bulldogs lead 13-10. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. He's in! Touchdown! And they take the lead. Still a long ways to go here in the 4th quarter, but that score has certainly put them in a great position to win the football game. And he adds the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. Time's running short here, so let's see what plays out.
I think it goes without saying that this is a very critical possession. They have to be thinking about getting the ball into the end zone because it's getting too late in the game to be thinking about field goals.
Throws it. That close to being intercepted.
Well, you want to do everything you can to keep the ball out of the hands of these receivers, so that was a really good effort.
2nd down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25. Runs right for a nice game. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. At the 30. He finally goes down at the 25. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. The middle for a nice game. Here's the halfback on the screen. He's gobbled up in the backfield.
Number 34 makes the tackle at the 22-yard line. 4th down.
It's 4th down, and they're going to try to go for it.
Four down.
He didn't get it. It's not even close. A score here might effectively end this one. Illinois is up four. Fires to the wideout, first down.
I tell you what, this defense better start to get pressure on the quarterback. They're giving him way too much time back there to throw the football.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw, and he's taken down at the 36-yard line.
Number 16 brings him down at the 36-yard line. That makes it second and six.
From their own 36-yard line. Second down.
Don't get nervous.
Heads out.
Fires that quickly, incomplete.
Barr was the intended receiver on the play. Third down.
Right and left, right and left. Four down.
Okay. Mike 34.
Heads out.
Send it.
Completes it, but he can't shake the defense.
Called a gain of 4 yards. That'll make it fourth and two.
They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. Oh, excellent punt. Lee takes it to 14, and he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Tackled after a decent run up the gut.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it second and four.
Off on the counter. He makes his way to about the 42. And now he's got room to run. Tackle outside after a nice pickup.
That'll bring up second and three.
Just under three to go in regulation. Throwing left. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds. Throws complete. He's got room to work. He's tackled at the 27. Like he flinched down there on the line.
False start, offense.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
It's second and six. Ball on the 32. Here's the give, and he hits him hard at the 30. The draw play gets maybe 2 yards. Got it complete. He's out of bounds.
That makes it first and ten.
He's going left. He tried to force it to a man that wasn't open, and boy, was he lucky it wasn't picked off.
He's got to be more careful when throwing the football into the end zone.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 20. Nice run there.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That'll make it 35.
Just under 2 minutes in the game. fires quickly, and he's got his man. Touchdown, and now they're in front. Oh, what a huge touchdown pass that is. Trying to go up by three, they'll kick the extra point. And he hits the PAT. A 10-play, 77-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So our score, 20-17. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. And he's tackled at the 29-yard line. Illinois has been unable to really show that they're the team to beat here, but it looks like they're going to get another chance at it.
Well, it's now or never. This team has put themselves in a position where they have to hope for some heroics late. It's because they played sloppy most of the game. They're very fortunate they still have a chance to be able to win this game.
In the shotgun and 5 wideouts. Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds. We've got a 1st and 10. Ball on their own 40.
Ready? Hey, check back 34. Mike 34.
That's a great tackle at the 34.
A loss of 6 yards on the play.
Check.
That'll make it 2nd and 1.
Throws out to the running back. No good.
The intended receiver.
And this 3rd and long is not a spot they wanted to be in. A little over a minute in the game. Sends it out quick, intercepted. And down he goes at about the 29-yard line. He steps up and makes a big turnover.
Yeah, he just made a huge play right there. He knew what was coming all along.
From the 29-yard line, it's 1st down. Brought down at the 31. Illinois will take their first time out of the half. Makes it out to about the 23. Illinois is going to have to use their 2nd time out of the half. You can see the elation on the defensive coordinator's side of things, and why not? His defense just came up with one of the biggest stops of the game in a vital spot in this 4th quarter. They're going to try a long field goal here. The kick is up, and he nails the long field goal. Louisiana Tech kicked this one off. Taken from the 3-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 20-yard line.
Well, this is a very competitive game. Just when you think one team has gained the advantage or the momentum, the other team comes fighting back, and it's going back and forth. This is almost like a basketball game.
Even in a game this close, I think it's going to take something very unexpected to change the outcome. But that doesn't mean it won't happen. And he is drilled at the 27-yard line. Under a minute left. And he stops the clock with a spike.
That'll bring up 3rd and 2.
It's 3rd down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Flags are all over the place, and they'll blow it dead.
False start. Offense.
It'll be 3rd down again after that penalty.
Yeah, now they have more yards to pick up for the 1st down.
Throws out, got his back again. bounces off a would-be tackler, and they push him out around the 25-yard line. The man defense proves to be too tough against the screen.
That was an excellent job by the defenders. They fought off their blocks and found the ball before the play had a chance to develop.
And if they don't get this one, you can start to warm up the bus. You can talk about offense all you want, and they were good today, but the defense was better. They come up with a play of the day, and that'll lead to the victory. This might be it. They've got the lead, but if they add to it, they know they've got a victory. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. He takes a knee. Illinois will take their final timeout.
Two times.
From the 19-yard line, it's second down. And the quarterback's going to take a knee to drain this clock and any hopes the opposition may have had. So this one's in the books, and we saw a great one here today. 23-17, Bulldogs. 23. And that's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.